Dearly beloved, we are blessed to have you once again join us in our study of God's holy and divine word. I'm Evangelist Joseph A. Brown. I just want you to know that it is always a blessing to have this opportunity to come before you with God's divine and holy word and understanding the Father's heart. And dearly beloved, one thing is for sure, that our God desire that we understand him and know him in a very personal way. Father, we come before you right now, thanking you for being the living God that you are. Thanking you, Father God, for being the source of life, and Father God, for being the one that guides us and also keep us, Father. For Father God, we realize that we cannot keep ourselves, but we need you in every aspect of our lives. So, Father, we ask in the name of Jesus Christ that as your word go forth this day, that you will bless it and cause it to prosper, even as the soul prosper of those who hear it. Father God, I pray that you will give them hearing ears and seeing eyes, that they might know you in a very personal way. Father, we thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Praise be to the living God. The Lord put upon my heart to share something with you this day in his holy and divine word. And the focus that we want to look into is enter into holiness. Amen. I believe sometimes that that word holiness is many times taken out of context, because you find people trying to display holiness as though they are holy because of the clothes they wear or the attitude that they might carry about in living. But dearly beloved, it is deeper than that. There is a part that you must play, and there's a part that God plays in you being holy or walking in holiness. Like I said, there is acting holy and there is entering into holiness, which is two separate different things. Because you can look at the outside of something and believe that it is something that it's really not. It's like if you were in Hollywood and you look at a facade of a building, that building may look real to you, but once you get on the inside, you realize that there is nothing but wilderness on the backside of it, because it's nothing but a facade. But you walk into something that is real, like a real house, then there is furnishings and there is plumbing and there is lights. There are different type of things that you will see. And dearly beloved, that's what we call entering in holiness, because there is blessings and promises to the believer who enter into the holiness of Almighty God. Amen. Praise be to God. The word reads in 2 Corinthians, the 7th chapter, the very first verse. Listen to these words. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, Paul writes, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Amen. Praise be to God. So Paul is writing here, and he's writing, he said, having for these promises, promises that is acquainted with believers and believers alone. He says, dearly beloved, let us do this. Cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and as well as the spirit. Amen. Now, God is calling us to a place as believers to walk in a certain kind of holiness. Yes, he's calling us to that place, and that is a holiness that is not only that can be seen, but a holiness that is unseen to many. And dearly beloved, he's calling us to be holy at all times. And this is what Paul is writing when he writes, cleanse ourselves from filthiness of the flesh. Now, we are called ourselves to cleanse ourselves from the things that we know that is filthiness to the flesh. He's not talking about, dearly beloved, making sure that you shower every day or that you have a bath every day. But he's talking about the deeds, the actions of the flesh, the ability when we allow our hands to do things that which is not God's will, or when we use our mouths to eat more than we should eat, that is called gluttony, or we use our lips to say things and condemn people, or use our lips to say things that are very negative, that will bring others down, especially those who are also believers. So, dearly beloved, he is calling us to cleanse ourselves of the filthiness that is of the flesh. Now, that will lead us into holiness as an individual. But let me say this. This holiness alone will not save you, because it's not about holiness that saves you. It's about holiness that allows you to walk in the promises of Almighty God. It is your confession. It is your belief. It is your trusting in the finished works of the Lord Jesus Christ that actually saves you. Amen. But the promises that God has for us on this side can only be gained through walking in holiness. Amen. So Paul tells them to cleanse themselves of the filthiness of the flesh and of the spirit. In other words, he's talking about that which works in the mind, that we allow things to settle in our mind, having the wrong thoughts toward people. Even though we may not say it, we really think it, and we allow it to incubate in our minds. And dearly beloved, when you allow things to incubate in your mind for a length of time, it will become negative, and you ultimately it will come out through your flesh. I remember sharing with a class one day that if you think about someone, or someone comes or appears in your mind that day, the best thing you can do for that person is begin immediately to pray for that individual. Don't start thinking about that person. Don't start allowing that person to inhabit your mind. Because you know what happened, dearly beloved? It won't take long before you begin to think negatively about that particular person. Amen? So we need to do our very best that when God allows someone to come into our mind, we need to begin to pray for them immediately. And only then will we be able to stay positive toward that person. Amen? Glory be to God. So that is very important that we do that. So yes, we can cleanse what? Our flesh, and we can cleanse our what? Spirit, so that we can be holy before God. Now look what the word goes on to say. Perfecting holiness in the fear of God. You see, as we walk that way, and as we do this, we are perfecting something, and that is perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Amen? There is a healthy fear of God. And when you and I walk in a way that we are putting aside that which is filthy, that which is no good, dearly beloved, we are then perfecting our fear of God. Because we are saying, Lord God, we are doing this because we have a perfected fear toward you, because of who you are, and because you're omniscient, because you know exactly what I am thinking, you know exactly what I have done. Father, you are aware of that. You are aware of the things that are done in darkness. I realize that. So Father, because of the reverent fear that I have for you, as your word says, the beginning of wisdom is the fear of God. The beginning of knowledge is the fear of God. So, dearly beloved, we are called to a place where we have to be willing to do something as a born again believer. God does not take everything away from us and leave us where we don't have to do anything at all but sit back. Dearly beloved, if that's what you do, then you will be bound up by Satan and you will be unusable for God. And dearly beloved, that is not a good place to be unusable by God, because God wants to use all of his vessels that he has called unto himself. He wants to use his children for his glory in the earth. That's why you and I live in the earth today, that we might glorify the Lord, that we might praise him, that we might lift him up. And dearly beloved, there's no better way to do that than by the life that we live. So God is calling us to a new way of living, and that's the only way that we can enter into holiness. So that is our part that we must do in order that we might understand what holiness is. And dearly beloved, within every born again believer, God has put a conscience in us that we know when we are doing wrong and when we are doing right. When we were in the world, there are many choices that we made that we did not know if it was right or if it was wrong. But dearly beloved, because we are born again believers, God has settled on the inside of us by his Holy and Divine Spirit. Now you and I can distinctly determine what is right and what is wrong before Almighty God. And this is what God is calling you and I to in the day that we live today, if we are going to walk in the holiness of Almighty God. We must be willing to participate in what we need to do before God. But in Hebrews, the 10th chapter, we want to talk a little more about entering into this holiness before Almighty God. In the 19th verse and the 10th chapter of Hebrews, the Word of God reads, "Having therefore, brethren," talking about the born again believers, not just anybody. Amen. You can cleanse yourself up as much as you want. You can use Ajax. You can use Tide. You can use whatever you want. But I say to you today, if you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ from the pardon of your sins and you have not been born again or understand even what that concept really means, let me say to you today, it doesn't matter all you do. That holiness to the Lord is as filthy rags. So as a person who said, I don't want to be born again, I don't want to know the Lord Jesus Christ in a personal way that is not me, because I don't want to be controlled by anything but myself, then I say to you today, then it does not matter. This, what I am sharing today, is not for you. It's only for, as the word says, having therefore brethren. Brethren means brothers and sisters that are in Christ. But I'm not putting you away. I want you to come to know him in a very personal way. I desire to have you as a brother in Christ or a sister in Christ. That's what my desire is. Amen. Praise be to God. That is very important. But if you are not that, then this simply is not for you. Now look what the word says. Having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Now, dearly beloved, this is a powerful word here that Paul has written here when he writes, boldness to enter into the holiest of the blood of Jesus. So the word of God is saying to you and I, if you are a born again believer, you can come boldly before the throne of grace because you have acknowledged that now you live by faith through the grace the Lord Jesus Christ has given you. So now we can enter boldly, glory be to God, boldly before the throne of grace and boldness to enter into the holiest. We can go before the Lord in the holiest of holy places. Do you realize, dearly beloved, that in the old covenant, that if someone entered the holy of holiest, that if they were not the high priest himself, and if the high priest had not made himself right before God, that he would be immediately slain before God. And they would have to drag him out of there, use poles to drag him out of there. And then a new high priest would be set in place before Almighty God. But dearly beloved, we can now enter into the holiest of holy because of our faith in the Lord's grace and our fact of being born again. And now we are children of the living God. So we can enter into the holiest of holy with boldness by what? By the blood of Jesus. Amen. So if you have not been covered by the blood of Jesus, then there's no way that you are able to enter into the holy of holiest. Amen? So entering in the holiest of holiest is God's way of making us holy. Amen? The other way is our way of making ourselves holy. But this way, God himself allow us to come in the holiest of holy, and dearly beloved, that alone make us holy. Hallelujah. Praise be to the living God. For instance, when you see someone wearing a robe or some type of cassock of some kind, it may be a priest, it may be a rabbi, whomever, or a preacher, whoever it might be. And even if it's just a person in general, maybe of the Hindu faith or the Muslim faith. One thing that we see when we see an individual dressed that way in a long robe, we immediately begin to think of that person being holy. Amen? I mean, if we're truthful about it, if we see those persons, a nun or whoever it may be, dress in a certain way, we give them the distinction of being holy, even though they may not even be born again, even though they may not even know the Jesus Christ as their Lord and their Savior, or even acknowledge him as the Son of God. Yet, we look at that person as being holy because of what they're wearing. And dearly beloved, I say to you today in the name of Jesus Christ, it's not about what you are wearing, but it is about what you are and what God is doing in you. So it is by the blood of Jesus that allow you and I to enter in the holiest of holiest. Not good acts, not because we are perfect, not because we have done everything right, not because we are cleansed to the uttermost. No, we are able to enter the holiest of holiest because the blood of Christ has cleansed us from our unrighteousness before God. So in other words, what our God sees and what our Father sees is the covering of the blood of Jesus Christ that has been spilled for the children of the living God who accepts that. Now look at the word, it says, by a new and living way. We're not coming before the Lord in a way where we bring offerings unto the Lord because of our good deeds and because we have done all the right things. We have given to the poor. We have given our tithes and we have given offerings. And because we have done that, now we can enter boldly before the throne of grace. No, dearly beloved, it is because you have been born again, and many people have been deceived in their hearts and their minds to believe that because they give, because they do this and that, that is what allowed them to be able to come before God. And because they have done this, they are in a space that believes that God ultimately owes them something because they have done something for the Lord. And dearly beloved, let me say to you, that's a dangerous place. And there are many people today who are sitting in buildings today, and they are saying to themselves, I am doing this and I am doing that, and I am paying and buying my way into heaven. And I know that God is noticing all my good deeds. Dearly beloved, they are living in a danger zone and do not even know it. Because it is because of the blood of Jesus that we are able to enter. And look what the word says. Now we can come, what? By a new and living way, not a dead way. Not the way where we have to make sacrifices of dead, of animals that would die before the Lord. But we are coming now in what way? We are coming now in a living way, which he had consecrated for us through the veil. He consecrated it. Glory be to God. He consecrated the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. He the one who said that if Jesus came and died for our sins, that that would be enough. And there would be nothing else that needed to be done but to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. He the one who made that possible. He's the one who said we don't have to believe in church covenants and all these things, but rather believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and then we will be saved. And the word says, in a new and living way, through the veil, that is to say, his flesh, Jesus' flesh. Glory be to God. God accepted that sacrifice when Jesus Christ said, it is finished on the cross. That's what he meant. There is no more sacrifices that needed to be made in order to make a nation holy or to make a person holy, but rather it was the belief in the Lord Jesus Christ and the things that he called you and I to walk in as a believer, as we said in the beginning of this study. Yes, dearly beloved, we can walk boldly in a new and a living way because of the flesh of Jesus Christ that died for our sins. There is no better thing to know in this life than to know the finished works of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the word says, and having an high priest over the house of God. Now, dearly beloved, we have a new high priest, and that new high priest is Jesus Christ, and he is over the house of God. He is over the church. Hallelujah. He is over the church. The word of God says that he is the head of the church. How can one say that Jesus Christ is not the ultimate one? How can one say that Jesus Christ is not the Savior when the word of God explicitly says that he is the head of the church and over the house of God? Glory be to the living God. Dearly beloved, we are blessed, and our God and our Father want us to know how much we are blessed. Hallelujah. Because we are now holy before God. And now God can use us as vessels to shape and to mold us in the way that he so desired, because now he can literally put his hand on us and mold us and shape us by his holy and divine spirit. Before that, dearly beloved, he could not even put his eyes upon us because of our lack of holiness before a holy God. Because of now the blood, we are holy before God, and now we can enter in a new and a living way, which is bold before God, because Jesus Christ is over the house of God. And that means, dearly beloved, he is over our lives. Let us now, look what the word said, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance. Make sure that your heart is full of full assurance. Glory be to God. We are assured now. We're not guessing about it. We don't have to say, Lord God, can I please come before you? Let me come before you, Lord. Oh, Lord, I humbly come before you in this way. No, the word says we can come boldly before the throne of grace. Hallelujah. Now, some will go back and say, you know what? The Pharisees came before the Lord and said he was he fasted twice a week. He did all these good deeds, and then there was the one who came before the Lord who pounded upon his chest and then said before the Lord, Lord, forgive me, a sinner. I have really sinned before you. And the Bible said, who went away being blessed or forgiven? And the word explicitly says whom? The Samaritan, the one who had bowed before the Lord. Now I want you to get this now, dearly beloved. It's very important that you get this. Remember, Jesus had not died yet. Amen? Jesus had not been sacrificed yet. So this man really had no choice but to come to the Lord in that way. But dearly beloved, according to the word now, we can come boldly before the throne of grace because of what Jesus did on the cross. This man had no choice but to come to the Lord the way he did. But now you and I can come boldly before the throne of grace. Now the word goes on to say, sprinkled from an evil conscience, and our bodies washed with pure water, which is the word. Amen. Praise be to the living God. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful of that promise. Glory be to God. God has made spectacular promises to you and I as a child of God. And dearly beloved, we need to walk in it. We need to enter into his holiness because of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. That's the only way that we can enter there it sufficiently, is because of what Jesus did and not because of who we are. Amen. Or what we have done in order to earn anything that we might call holiness. Glory be to God. Our Father, bless you this day. And we will ask you also to tune us in on Sunday mornings between the hours of 6 and 10 a.m. at KZJM 92.7, the People Station, where we are sharing the word of the living God. Or you can get us online at www.927kzjm.org. And I promise you that God will surely, surely bless you. And he will continue to bless you if you are a child of the living God. And I pray that when we come next week, that if you have not asked the Lord into your life, that you will do that very thing. And dearly beloved, know this, that God loves you and he died for you through the Lord Jesus Christ. And dearly beloved, be a blessing to someone today.